Good morning, Victory Word. Good morning, good morning. It's another good day in the neighborhood. Let's lift our eyes unto the hills from whence cometh our help, for our help cometh from the Lord. So, Victory Word, I need you to lift up your hearts and lift up your eyes. In these uncertain times, be certain of this, that God is still in charge of our lives. Amen. Good morning, good morning. It's another good day. We are glad that you are here to welcome. I'm here to welcome you to your word and your worship experience, your virtual word and worship experience. Hallelujah. Come on, let's give him a hand praise on today. For he is good and he is great and he is worthy to be praised. Amen. Amen. Good morning. Good morning. Pastor Mike and I are glad that you are tuning in. And you're continuing on wanting to be fed, and especially in times like these. We are thankful. We're thankful for each and every one of you this morning, Victory Word. And be encouraged. Stay encouraged. Our Victory Word vision, we usually say this corporately, and you say this corporately from where you are, so we can be in one. The Victory Word Church is a place where you will experience freedom in worship, connection with others through life-giving relationships, compassion for the lost, and the teaching of God's word in love. A place where lives are being changed, hurts are being healed, and hope is being restored. We are empowering lives to live purposely for him. Amen. Hallelujah. I'm going to get right to our announcements. We have a few announcements, and we're going to get out of the way because Pastor has a powerful word for us on today. So on this Sunday, March the 29th, this last Sunday of March the 2020, the quote of the week, stop being ashamed of how many times you've fallen. And start being proud of how many times you've gotten up. Amen. Remember, we are still in our first fruit season, so please continue to honor your first fruit pledge as the first Sunday in April is quickly approaching. We want you to tune in on Wednesday, April the 1st at 7 p.m. for our virtual Bible study. Come and get your 1 hour of power. I promise it'll bless you. Birthdays. Last week, I missed announcing the birth anniversary of our own sister, Ashley Mack. Hallelujah. Her birthday was she celebrated her birthday on Wednesday, March the 26th. Praise God, and may God continue to bless you and keep you to celebrate many, many, many more birth anniversaries. Also, remember, beloved, that although we are living in some uncertain times, we must continue to operate in faith and not in fear. And in doing so, we must still fulfill our financial obligations to the Lord in this ministry. So you can go to our website, www.victorywordchurch.org, and you can hit the giving button, and you can use your debit card to continue to help in the upbuilding of the kingdom of God. You can also make your donations via Cash App at $VWC212012. Cash App, VWC2012. For those who aren't comfortable with either of those options, you can also mail your donations to VWC, which is Victory Word Church, at P.O. Box 361200, Grosse Pointe, Michigan, 48236. That's P.O. Box 361200, Grosse Pointe, Michigan, 48236. If you need to reach Pastor Mike or myself, or need to set up an appointment, just hit us up on the church office phone at 313-243-4512, and we will gladly assist you. If you have need for a special prayer, and I think we all do in these days and times, but if you have something else going on with you besides this new norm, please make your prayer request at www.victorywordprayerrequest@gmail.com, or go to our website, www.victorywordchurch.org, and hit the prayer request tab, and it will go directly to our pastor, and he will pray with and for you. Our prayers are purposeless. Our Victory Word Church family, Pastor DL and First Lady Harville and New Life Ministries Worldwide family, the Spiritual Church and its Army family, Pastor Remarco and First Lady Pittman and the New Prosperity Baptist Church, Bishop Leonard Gardner and family, Pastor Gregory and Lady Smith and the Zion Hill Baptist Church, Pastor James and First Lady Rains and the Ecclesia Christian Church, Pastor James and First Lady Minnick and the Mount Pleasant Missionary Baptist Church, Brother Mark Jalen Oliver, Sister Kayla Marshall, Sister Marcina Golden, and Sister Leslie Mills Golden, our college students, amen. Brother MJ Oliver, Pastor Aura and Minister LaRue Clay, Sister Marsha White, Sister Tina White, Sister Zeddy White, Minister Carol Hicks, Vonnie Brown, Lamar Hall, Adele Lathan, Pastor Marks, Pastor James Marks and family, and our sister church, Victory Word, located in the country of India, Pastor Mose Daniel and family in our Victory Word Church located in the country of Kenya, all of the school systems that have been affected by this virus, and our first responders, especially our AP Mark Oliver, and Nurse Angie Cheatham, and all others that are still going out in the workforce. May God continue to bless and keep each and every one of you, and a special prayer for the sick and shut in and the bereaved at this time. If you have anyone to add to our prayers and purpose list, just give us a call at 313-243-4512. Don't forget to go to our Facebook page every Monday for the awesome anointed word of the week. And remember, we are living our future now. Amen. Put those blessed hands together as we receive our pastor, the shepherd of Victory Word Church, Dr. M.K. Oliver. Hallelujah.
Good morning, Victory Word. Good morning, good morning, good morning. I've been waiting all week long to worship God with an anointed vessel just like you. It's another good day. Did you hear what I just said? It's another good day to have a God day. I love you to life, and Christ Jesus loves you all the more. We're here today, Victory Word, in our virtual church today, telling God thank you, telling him we love him for all that he is doing in this day and in this season. Amen. God is still good.
Yes.
God is still good.
Yes, he is.
It's another good day. Why? Because he woke us up this morning.
Yes.
Allowed us to see another day that we've never seen before.
Yes.
And for that reason, we just want to say thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
You ought to high five your neighbor and just say, I'm glad to be in service one more time. One more time, God. We thank you for allowing us to be here one more time. I'm going to ask Pastor T to come back with me for just a few moments. I'm going to ask us all to hold hands wherever you are with your loved ones this morning, because it is definitely, this is the hour of prayer. We definitely need to pray. We definitely need to know that God is still with us. Most gracious Father, we thank you right now because of who you are. Not only because you are our God, but you are our Father. And Father, we thank you right now in this season, Father, this challenging season where we're not able to go and see our loved ones face to face, and we're not able to do our regular things that we've done in the past. But God, you said in your word, you wouldn't leave us nor forsake us. And for that, we just want to say thank you. We bless your name and we love you. Father, continue to take care of our families. Take care of first responders. Let's take care of each other, Lord. We love you, we praise you, and we magnify your name. That is our prayer this morning, and it is so. And it is so. And
it is so.
In Jesus' name, amen, and praise God. Amen. Amen. I was thinking today, and also listening to my pastor, and he made a great point this morning, that there's a lot of folks that may be connected or watching that doesn't have a church home. And I want you to know Victory Word is your church. And if you'd like to become a member of our church, all you'd have to do is call us at 313-243-4512. We'll answer the phone and we'll take you in as a member of the Victory Word Church, because this is a judgment-free zone. We don't beat you up. We lift you up and we watch God pick you up. Amen. Amen. So let's get into the word today, coming from Isaiah. Isaiah, the 26th chapter, 7th through the 10th verse, and the 20th and 21st verses, reading from the Message Bible. And it reads, The path of right living people is level. The leveler evens the road for the right living. We're in no hurry, God. We're content to linger in the path signposted with your decisions. Who you are and what you've done are all we'll ever want. Through the night, my soul longs for you. Deep from within me, my spirit reaches out to you. When your decisions are on public display, everyone learns how to live right. Amen. Everyone learns how to live right. The 20th verse, it says, come, my people, go home and shut yourselves in. Go into seclusion for a while until the punishing wrath is past, because God is sure to come from his place to punish the wrong of the people on earth. Earth itself will point out the blood stains. It will show where the murdered have been hidden away. I want to concentrate on, come my people, go home and shut yourselves in. Go into seclusion for a while until the punishing wrath is past. I want to preach just for a few moments this morning. It's time to shift. And where do we go from here? Sisters and brothers, we have to ask ourselves this question in this season. Lord, where do we go from here? Where do we go from here? Well, the first thing that we must do while we're in this situation is to build up our relationship with God. The God that woke us up this morning, the God that allowed us to breathe in and breathe out. We need to learn how to build up this particular, we need to build up this relationship. We've built up relationships with our children. We've built up relationship with our spouses. We've built up relationship with our friends on our job. But the question is, are we building up a great relationship with our Father, the one that woke us up this morning? We need to build up that relationship. We ought to be able to know that in this season, that God won't leave us nor forsake us. He hasn't brought us thus far to leave us. All we have to do is continue to hold on to God's hand. We have to hold on. Hold on to God's unchanging hand. In this season, we've had to shift. We can't just go out the way we used to go out. We can't just hang with our friends. We can't just do what we've been doing. Why? Because this is the season of shifting. We have to shift. We have to shift and understand that God will do just what he said he would do. So hold on to God's unchanging hand. There must be an urgency in spirit to please God. How you work your shift will decide your pay. Did you hear that? How you work your shift. How you work your shift will decide your pay. How you handle yourself in this situation will show how much more your relationship has gotten stronger with God. Because this is the time for a faith walk. For we walk by faith and not by sight. If you want your pay to go up higher, then work your shift, baby. Work your shift. Know that this shift is a 24-hour shift. It's not 8 hours, not 12 hours. It's a 24-hour shift. And we have to understand and know in this shift, God's going to pay us. How is he going to pay us? He's going to pay us by giving us a peaceful mind, a joyful heart. We understand that even though I can't go out the way I used to go out, I'm still able to go outside and walk and do different things in my little area and be thankful for that. We have to continue to be thankful. Victory Word and all our friends, we need to be thankful. Don't get depressed. I know we got cabin fever. I know we want to just go rip and run. But this is the season, as the scripture has said, to stay in. Stay in. There's a lot of people that are still walking around doing things the way they want to do it. But I'm here to pray for those who can't think enough of others to follow the guidelines that has been given to us by the governor and by the ones that have rule over us. It's amazing to me how us as ministers and pastors want the church to submit to us, and we can't submit to the ones that's over us at this time. So I'm challenging you. I'm challenging you to be safe. To be safe. This is not the time to say that I can do what I want to do, when I want to do it, how I want to do it. No, sisters and brothers, this is the time to love and serve one another by thinking of someone else besides yourself. Amen? Amen. Your feet will never take you where your mind has never been. You got to get your mind into a place that you are able to hear God when he speaks. Because your feet can't take you where your mind hasn't been. So the Bible tells us, let this mind be in you that was also in Christ Jesus. We have to have the mind of Christ right now, sisters and brothers. Not only now, but we should have been having it anyway, especially us that are the believers. We have to understand and know that God is still God. And if I have the mind of Christ, that means I'm going to think of others. I'm going to treat people right, even if they don't treat me right. I know it's a rough deal. I know it's hard to do sometimes. Especially it's hard to treat people right when you think or when they think they didn't got over on us. We have to really, you know how we are as people. We don't like anyone to think they got the upper hand over us. But in this season, we've learned it doesn't matter. All those things, I bet most of us, the things we've been upset about, been mad about, all of those things, it doesn't even matter right now, does it? Doesn't even matter. All you're thinking about is survival. All you're trying to do is make it to the next day and not go stir crazy in the house. And learning how to communicate with your spouse or your children. Yes, a lot of us haven't been with our family like we used to be. And now this has brought us back together to be able to eat at the dinner table together, to sit down and talk, to sit down and open up our hearts. The other night, myself, my son, and Pastor T, we sat down at the table and we were playing Uno, and I thought I was going to win, thought I would be the big winner. But of course, Pastor T won majority of the games, and Mark Jalen, he won next most, and your pastor came in last, and I'm a sore loser. But God, we've learned how to come together here at home and love on one another. And I know you need to do the same thing in your home. Put past situations and circumstances, stop keeping score, who did this, who did that. It's just time to love. Just love. This is the season to love. Amen? Amen. And guess what, church? God will not put more on you than you can bear. That's in 1 Corinthians 10 and 13. God's not going to put on you no more than you can bear. Guess what? Any temptation that you fall into, he always makes a way for us to escape. But sometimes the temptation, whatever it is, it feels good to our flesh, and we decide to fall in. So God sometimes allows things to happen to pull us out, to get pulled out from things that may be detrimental to you. And so, sisters and brothers, in this shift season, in this shifting season, I need you to start thinking like, Lord, what's my next move? Because every good idea, and always remember this, every good idea is not a God idea. I got to get more in tune to God. What is his plans for me? Which way does he want me to move? How does he want me to go? Where does he want me to go? Is this the job you want me to do? And just because I'm good at it doesn't mean I'm anointed for it. A lot of us do jobs and have been doing things in our life just because we were good at it. But is that your true calling? This season might be the season for you to sit down and talk to your Father spiritually and ask him, Lord, is this the way I'm supposed to go? Is this the area I'm supposed to be in? I ask you, Father, to order my steps. The Bible says that the steps of a good man or a righteous man is ordered by the Lord. So I want to look from this season, when we're able to get back to our normal, regular lives, you got to have a stronger ear to hear what God is saying to you and not just put your own feelings, emotions, endeavors in front of what God is saying. Because he's shifting us. He's shifting us. He's shifting the church world. He's shifting the business world. He's shifting the educational world. He's shifting everything for us. He's getting our attention. This is the season. He says, listen, I'm getting the world's attention for us to go back to understanding that we must do what? Love and serve one another. And guess what, church? God will not put more blessings on you than you can bear either. Yeah. Everybody wants a blessing, wants this, wants that. Lord, bless me. Well, let me tell you, the first blessing that he did is waking you up this morning, allowing you to see this day. I think we take these intangible blessings for granted, but don't take it for granted when you're able to walk on your own, that you're able to breathe on your own. There's so many of our brothers and sisters in the hospital can't breathe on their own. There were brothers and sisters that were with us last week that are not here this week. And so we ought to say, Lord, I thank you for what you're doing for me because you keep on blessing me over and over and over again. Because if it had not been for the Lord who was on our side, and I'm here to tell you today, he is on our side. And guess what? There is a brighter day ahead. Yes. Brighter days are coming. Don't you get caught up in this season of gloom and doom, because we are the body of Christ. We are baptized believers in Christ, knowing that God will not leave us nor forsake us. He will keep us. He's kept us this much. He's kept us all this time. So I'm trusting and believing that he's going to keep us through danger seen and unseen. But I got to use wisdom. I got to use wisdom. When he says stop, stop. When he says go, go. That's what we have to do, sisters and brothers. We have to open up our ear, our spiritual ear, to hear what the Lord is saying in this season. Where do we go from here? We go with God. That's where we go from here. We go with God. God is our captain. And I believe we're fighting for a captain, as the old saints used to say, a captain that's never lost a battle. So be encouraged today. Know that God will do just what he said he would do. Pick up your Bible. Take some time to read it. In this scripture today, it says that he's a leveler. In other words, our God will keep us balanced in an imbalanced season. He will keep you balanced in an imbalanced season. There are a lot of people working in first response. They're seeing things and seeing death at an alarming rate. But I'm here to tell you that I love you. I'm praying for all of us, especially those that's on the front line, that's going through. Because guess what? You're going through, but you're not through going. Listen, sisters and brothers, don't get your vision mixed up with your sight. There's a lot of people that have sight but don't have vision. And in this shifting season, you must have vision. Vision, not sight. Because a lot of people see a lot of things, but vision goes into a spiritual place in us where we can go beyond what we see so that we can see what we don't see. That's vision. God has put vision in us. It's just time for us to open up our spiritual eyes and see. Stop all of the things that's stopping you from being happy. I mean, true happiness. I'm not talking about the happiness that's based upon what's happening around you. I'm talking about the happiness that's based on what's going on inside of you. That's where we have to get to. That's what we must do. Victory Word and all of our friends that's tuning into this Facebook Live service, let's go back to the old landmark. Loving and serving one another. Real love. The Bible says love covers a multitude of sin. It didn't say it justified it. It didn't say it didn't recognize it. It said love, it covers it. In other words, let's stop exposing each other's inadequacies and ask God to love them. And let us be the instrument of love so that we can be the people that God is calling for such a time as this. Amen. What you demonstrate in your everyday walk speaks to the vision you possess. What you do in your everyday living speaks to your vision. Speaks to what type of vision you really have. Because guess what, sisters and brothers? Some people are never going to pick up the Bible. The only Bible they know is you. They come to you with their issues, their problems, all kinds of things. And the question is, how are you going to respond? How are you going to shift and see what God has called you to speak into that person's life? So Victory Word and all of our friends that's watching, I just want to say on behalf of myself, Pastor T, we love you. Victory Word, we love you. And our friends around the country and whoever is watching today, I want you to know we love you. And guess what? God loves you all the more. Victory Word, we'll be right back here Wednesday for our 1 hour of power in our Bible study. Don't forget to just pick up the phone. You can't go and see everyone, but pick up the phone and call someone. Check on the seniors. When I get done today, I got to call my mother and my father and check on them. Those that have aunts and uncles or friends or whoever it may be, pick up the phone and call. Let them know that they're not alone, that God hasn't forsaken them, and that everything is going to be all right. Remember, Victory Word, we're living our future now. God bless you.